Change of time, all physicians' offices, clinics, and hospitals are required to have electronic health records, or EHRs, by 2015. And this is going to create lots of new jobs, and one local community college is ready to prepare you to seize the opportunity of a new career. And Kelly Patterson with Hinds Community College is here with more on the school's training program. Good morning to you.
Good morning.
All right, and explain to us how the program will train folks get ready for these new jobs that are going to be created.
Well, through the Office of the National Coordinator on Health Information Technology, they have developed a community college consortia across the nation to train individuals to help these physicians' offices and clinics transition to electronic health records, and Hinds is proud to be part of that. We're offering two roles, a technical software training role and a trainer role, to train individuals how to teach end users to use electronic health records in these offices, healthcare, in other healthcare settings as well.
Now, will this be a traditional student, or that you would have a Hinds Community College going for a couple of years, or is this just a very limited?
It's very limited. It's all online. It's to be completed in 6 months or less. And upon completion, they're eligible to sit for a national competency exam called the Health Information Technology Professionals Exam. And the good news about that competency exam is that there's the first 27,500 individuals to take the test take it for free. So this will also prepare them. This competency exam sets them up for success in job finding and helping with electronic records.
And when can folks start signing up for this program?
Well, our next class starts April 4th. So this class is already underway, but we have two more classes in June and September. And they can go to our website at hindscc.edu/EHR to download an application and see admission criteria.
And are you all looking for a specific type of person for this program?
Well, it varies on the role that they're applying for. We like to see that they have information technology background for the technical software support role, and then some electronic health record background for the trainer role to set them up for success in the program.
All right, Kelly Patterson, thank you so much.
Thank
Appreciate
you.
It.
All right.